I'll never know how things would have worked out should I have gotten elected as governor, but I'm better for it. And I look back with no regrets at all during the race last time around. I'm deeply committed to continuing to do my small part to bring people together and to make government work better once again. And I think the attitude and the hallmark of most of the leaders, the people here in the state of Maine that are elected, believe in that as well. They people who fight passionately, they care deeply, and at the end of the day, they come together to do what's right, just like Senator Margaret Chase Smith has always done during her political career. We paved the way a new path forward and remind us that a divided nation is not good for us as a nation. And in her memory and for the sake of our future, let us all recommit ourselves to finding that true center, because you can get so much more done in that regard. Actually, I see Charlie Cragen out there in the hall. I know Charlie is a veteran. He has, since he left public office, he's continually fight for our veterans' issues. And when you look at the veterans' issues and what happened during the last Congress with everything at the Department of Veterans Affairs, that could have been a disaster. The Republicans very easily could have blamed this administration for the failures within the Department of Veterans Affairs. The Democrats could have blamed the Republicans and said, well, no, it started under President George Bush. But what Chairman Miller, my Republican colleague from Florida, did, and I, we sat down and said, look, we've got a huge problem here within the department. We've got to find solutions on how to solve what the department is going through. And there's no way we're going to be able to do that by keep pointing fingers at one another. Both he and I committed to working together to try to identify the problems, find the solutions. And if you look during that last year in Congress when we were able to work through the Department of Veterans Affairs problems, we actually did come up with a unanimous report. We went to the committee of conference, the first time it's been done in years, and we actually were able to find a common ground where we're able to move this legislation forward and onto the president's desk for his signature. It was a tough task because on our side of the aisle, what it meant was we actually, in this first time in the Veterans Affairs Committee history, we actually had to issue subpoenas to the Department of Veterans Affairs. And there were my motions to do that, which is unusual for a Democrat to issue a subpoena under the Democratic administration or vice versa. Republican administration. But it was the right thing to do because we needed that information for us to move forward. We had a very positive outcome in that regard. So I'm very pleased with that. And I encourage each and every one of you here today to not give up on elected officials. Constantly keep after them to do the right thing. And you'll have to weigh in your own mind on how much rhetoric that they're giving you as far as what they say the issues are of the day. Because it's important. It's important for these young students over here, which I'm glad to see, and hopefully eventually that they'll get involved in politics once they get up of age. And as I was telling them a little bit earlier, someone asked me in high school if I was going to ever be involved in politics. I would have said, you're crazy. There's no way I was going to do that. But look where I ultimately became member of the United States Congress. So thank you very much for having me here. I guess we have questions and answers. May God bless each and every one of you. And before I take the questions and answers, I will also ask each and every one of you to keep in mind men and women who are still in harm's way around the world, fighting for us as a country. Keep them in your thoughts and your prayers. Because they definitely need all the help and thoughts and prayers that we can give. So without any further ado, thank you very much. Appreciate being here.